blessing. He chastens and hastens his will to make known. The wicked oppressing now cease from distressing. Sing praises to his name. He forgets not his own.
Beside us to guide us, our God with us joining, ordaining, maintaining his kingdom divine. So from the beginning, the fight we were winning, thou, Lord, were at our side. All glory be thine.
We all do extol thee, thou leader triumphant, and pray that thou still our defender will be. Let thy congregation escape tribulation, thy name be ever praised, O Lord, make us free.
Let us read responsively the words of Psalm 65, Thanksgiving for Earth's Bounty. Praise is due to you, O God, in Zion, and to you shall vows be performed. O you who answer prayer, to you all flesh shall come. When deeds of iniquity overwhelm us, you forgive our sin, our transgressions. Happy are those whom you choose and bring near to live in your courts. We shall be satisfied with the goodness of your house, your holy temple. By awesome deeds you answer us with deliverance, O God of our salvation. You are the hope of all the ends of the earth and of the farthest seas. By your strength you establish the mountains, you are girded with might. You silence the roaring of the seas, the roaring of their waves, the tumult of the peoples. Those who live at earth's farthest bounds are awed by your signs. You make the gateways of the morning and the evening shout for joy. You visit the earth and water it. You greatly enrich it. The river of God is full of water. You provide the people with grain, for so you have prepared it. You water its furrows abundantly, settling its ridges, softening it with showers, and blessing its growth. You crown the year with your bounty. Your wagon tracks overflow with richness. The pastures of the wilderness overflow. The hills gird themselves with joy. The meadows clothe themselves with flocks. The valleys deck themselves with grain. They shout and sing together for joy. A reading from Luke, the 17th chapter. On the way to Jerusalem, Jesus was going through the region between Samaria and Galilee. As he entered a village, 10 lepers approached him. Keeping their distance, they called out, saying, "Jesus, Master, have mercy on us." When he saw them, he said to them, "Go and show yourselves to the priests." And as they went, they were made clean. Then one of them, when he saw that he was healed, turned back, praising God with a loud voice. He prostrated himself at Jesus' feet and thanked him. And he was a Samaritan. Then Jesus asked, "Were not 10 made clean? But the other 9, where are they? Was none of them found to return and give praise to God except this foreigner?" Then he said to him, "Get up and go on your way. Your faith has made you well." The Gospel of the Lord. Let us join in praying together the prayer of the day. Almighty God, our Father, your generous goodness comes to us new every day. By the work of your Spirit, lead us to acknowledge your goodness, give thanks for your benefits, and serve you in willing obedience through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen.
Some days we forget to look around us. Some days we can't see the joy that surrounds us. So caught up inside ourselves, we take when we should give. So for tonight we pray for what we know can be, and on this day we hope for what we still can't see. It's up to us to be the change, and even though we all can still do more, there's so much to be thankful for. Look beyond ourselves, there's so much sorrow. It's way too late to say I'll cry tomorrow. Each of us must find our truth. It's long, so long overdue. So for tonight we pray for what we know can be, and every day we hope for what we still can't see. It's up to us to be the change, and even though we all can still do more, there's so much to be thankful for. Even with our differences, there is a place we're all connected. Each of us can find each other's light. Tonight we pray for what we know can be, and on this day we hope for what we still can't see. It's up to us to be the change, and even though this world needs so much more, there's so much to be thankful for.
Let us pray. Gracious Heavenly Father, open our eyes that we may see the needy among us, and open our hearts so that we might know how we might reach out with your hands and your feet to take care of the ones you have called us to love with compassionate hearts. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. The year 2020 is shaping up to be like no other year that we have experienced in our lifetimes. As we come to the day of Thanksgiving, we might wonder, for what? When all we can see is empty churches, bars, and restaurants, when we're challenged by unemployment or work slowdowns, when the rent is coming due at the end of the month and we have no idea how the rent is going to be paid, when we drive by the food distribution centers and wonder if this is the year that we will have to become a taker, a receiver instead of a giver, when we see clouds in the horizon or thunderheads on the horizon, we may wonder, thanks for what this year? Our psalm lays it out for us. There is an incredible bounty in God's kingdom. The voice of the psalmist is joyful as he proclaims the many blessings that God has given to us. And in our gospel lesson, our Lord sees a group of lepers who have been socially distanced, who understand the meaning of that word for a long time. They're not allowed to come close to others because of their danger. But Jesus is moved to compassion. And after Jesus heals them and they go on their way to the priest, there is one who sees. He stops. He turns around. He sees that he has been healed. He sees that Jesus is the healer. That one, without the priest's blessing, without the proof or the certificate of cleanliness that he might receive from the priest, he sees and he turns around and he gives thanks. The master has healed him and he returns to his master. But the others don't see the master for who he is. They only see themselves. They only see their own conditions. They are only anxious to see a priest to get a clean bill of health, not recognizing that they already have it. What do we see? And what do we fail to see this year? This year, many parents have become homeschool teachers. When we got married and had children, we can say that we probably didn't sign up to become teachers in a home school. Pastors and secretaries have become visual artists and graphic programmers on computers. When we went to the seminary, or when we developed our office skills, we didn't take courses on live streaming or on webcam management. And when churches closed their buildings last spring, it hit a lot of us hard because we weren't used to home churching. Gatherings for food and for coffee at the local restaurant used to be an event for social support, one where we developed our relationships with our neighbors. And now we are told that it is a very high potential hotspot for super spreaders, a place to be avoided. Life is different. But like the lepers, as we find ourselves socially distanced, what do we see and what do we fail to see? Are we still able to see God's daily blessings to us in this time of pandemic? Or do the cataracts that have formed on our eyes cause us to miss the blessings that are still right before us? And what will it take for us to once again, with 2020 vision,
celebrate God's goodness. Our prayer this year is, open our eyes, Lord. We want to see Jesus. Our prayer this year is, Lord, help me to slow down in my chaotic life so that I can take inventory, not of what I don't have, but what I do have. Help me to see that even though it may be difficult for us to gather in worship with our neighbors, it's not just about me, it's not just about my needs. The church is still open. The church is active, doing God's work of bringing food to the hungry, helping provide clothing for the poor, bringing justice to the oppressed, and reaching out to those suffering in mind or body and spirit. And I am called to be a part of that work. This year, I've asked a number of people to join together to help us to open our eyes. So often we fail to give thanks for the blessings that God has put right before us. And I invite you to take off your blinders today to see that the work of God in our midst still goes on in our corner of the world. I invite you to join together in this tapestry of praise and thanksgiving, to gather with your sisters and brothers as one, even in our distancing, to take inventory of the incredible blessings we have and to ask the Lord's blessing on this day, for our time, for these days of pandemic. We need to open our eyes and see Jesus. Yes, see Jesus among the needy, among those whom God has called us to reach out and help. I invite you to see Jesus and all of God's gifts this year in a completely different way. Open our eyes, Lord. Amen. It has not been easy being church during this COVID crisis. Church, by definition, is a community of the faithful. And when it is difficult for us to gather safely, when going to church means worshiping with a very few at best, with limited ability to visit afterwards, things just aren't the same. Pastors and leaders are both exhausted, demoralized, and struggling with the choices because none of the choices seem very pleasant. Yet the Church of God, which has endured centuries of struggle, goes on. And we thank God for the way church is happening outside our buildings. It's happening through phone calls, in cards that are sent, in our own places of work where we tap into the resources of our faith to maintain a godly presence. This year, we say thanks to God for the privilege of being church in this time and in this place. For as we are promised, Christ is our cornerstone, a rock upon which we can build. Let us pray. Gracious God, it is good for us to gather as your beloved in community. We treasure your presence with us in word and meal, in song and prayer. Be with us in these days when gathering together as often as we would like is not possible. When we must be apart for reasons of safety, we trust that you surround us with your sheltering wings. Encourage us in connecting as we are able. Encourage us as we are reaching out to our neighbors in need, and help us to be persistent in prayer. We ask this in the name of Jesus, our constant, companion who will never let go. Amen. Let us give thanks to God for our communities of faith and for all who are called into leadership positions in our church.
Almighty God, your Holy Spirit equips the church with a rich variety of gifts. Grant that we may use them to bear witness to Christ in lives that are built on faith and love. Make us ready to live the gospel and eager to do your will, so that we may share with all your church in the joys of eternal life. We ask your favor upon our Savior's Lutheran as they enter into the call process and a time of discernment as they seek out their next servant of God to bring word and sacrament to them. We remember also the ministries of the Southwest Minnesota Synod staff, as well as the pastors and leaders of this synod, that with patience and understanding, they may love and care for your people. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
Let us pray. Eternal God, your love is stronger than death, and our passion more fierce than the grave. We rejoice in the lives of those whom you have drawn into your eternal embrace. Keep us in joyful communion with them until we join the saints of every people and nation gathered before your throne in your ceaseless praise. In these days when our neighbors and friends have died from the coronavirus, we pray for the families left behind who can no longer celebrate the lives of loved ones and grieve their deaths in ways we have celebrated and grieved in the past. Be present especially with the Ashburn family who mourn the death of Jerry. Sustain them by the hope of your resurrection, for your promise that by your love, nothing can separate us from you. Through Christ our Lord. Amen.
When Minnesota businesses were asked to close down last March and April, certain stores were asked to stay open, among them being grocery stores. Today we say thanks to God for all who have continued to work despite the adjustments that they have had to make and in spite of the possible dangers to personal health. Let us pray. This year, O Lord, we are mindful of all who work and shop in grocery stores. As we depend on them for our necessary provisions, and as they are unable to close their doors, we ask your special protection upon their workers who stock the shelves, check out the customers, and obtain the food, and upon all who come in to purchase their needs. They are your servants, O Creator, who help to share of your abundance to all. Through Jesus Christ, our providing Lord, we pray. Amen. It has been a hard year for the food service industry. Many restaurants and food providers have had to close their doors. Today we say thanks to all the workers in our area that work in the food industry and pray for their welfare. Let us pray. This year, O Lord, we are truly grateful for the restaurants and for their workers who provide food for the hungry and open places where we can enjoy the blessings of visiting with one another and sharing the blessings of life. This year, as many find their livelihoods threatened by restrictions and closures due to the coronavirus, give each of us a heart to reach out to them in generous and compassionate ways that will let them continue their ministries of hospitality. May the day soon come when we can once again gather around tables and counters without fear and celebrate your gift of daily bread with one another through Jesus our Lord. Amen. It has been a difficult year for our agricultural workers, for farmers, for livestock managers, for processors, etc. When food processing factory workers have had to quarantine, the impact on cattle or pig or chicken operations has been dramatic. Even now, as families are asked to forego gatherings around the table, it has become difficult for many grocery stores to sell turkeys. One thing about farmers, they are gifted with the knowledge that everything depends on God. They know that there is no guarantee of a bountiful harvest with good prices every year. And yet, despite the lack of guarantees, they persist. Today we say thanks for our farmers and our agricultural community. Let us pray. Most gracious God, according to your wisdom, the deep waters are opened up and clouds drop gentle moisture. We praise you for the return of planting and harvest seasons, for the fertility of the soil, for the harvesting of the crops, and for all other blessings that you in your generosity pour out on your people. Give us a full understanding of your mercy, that our lives may show respect and care for your creation. In these days of low prices, guide our farmers as they make plans for next year's crops. Provide for their needs and guide them as they provide food for the world through Christ our Lord and our provider. Amen.
O God, source of all goodness, we give you thanks for the gift of reason and the opportunity for education. We lift up to you the schools in our area, Echo Charter, McRae, Renville County West, and Yellow Medicine Schools. Make them places of learning and safety where teachers challenge the minds and nurture the hearts of students.
In this time, when teachers, parents, and students are challenged by new ways of online and physical distance learning, bring calm to children who are fearful from all they hear and see around them. Patience in times of school closures and guidance for school administrators as they make decisions. Help all to work in atmosphere and of cooperation and understanding, that we may yet find joy and success as our youth are prepared with skills and aptitudes for their lives. Through Christ we pray. Amen.
This has been a hard year for those in recovery ministry. That is ministry to those who are alcoholics, gambling addicts, people that have difficulty with mental health issues even at home. As tensions increase with the virus going out of control around us, we tend to become short with each other. We lean on the false gods that we can see, chemicals or alcohol, maybe shopping or TV or screen time on computers, all of which invite us to take care of ourselves first. In seeking to be free of restrictions, free to do what we want, we become slaves to self, and our lives spiral out of control. In these days when the needs for recovery ministry are great, we give thanks to God for all who work in this ministry, who remind us that we are powerless, and that admitting our powerlessness is the first step to recovery and to health. Let us pray.
Oh, blessed Jesus, you minister to all who came to you. Look with compassion upon all who through addiction have lost their health and freedom. Restore to them the assurance of your unfailing mercy. Remove the fears that attack them. Strengthen those who are engaged in the work of recovery, and to those who care for and live with them, give them honesty, understanding, and persevering love. For your mercy's sake, amen. I love that prayer.
Serve and protect. That's their marching orders. But this year, it hasn't been easy. When a 911 call comes in asking for help to get to the hospital, they run the risk of becoming ill themselves. Yet when others flee, they jump in to do what is necessary. This year, we say thanks to God for all who serve and protect. Let us pray.
God of earth and air, water and fire, height and depth, we pray for those who work in danger, who rush in to bring hope and help and comfort. When others flee to safety, whose mission is to seek and save.
Serve and protect, and whose presence embodies the protection of the Good Shepherd, give them caution and concern for one another so that in safety they may do what must be done under your watchful eye.
Protect them from the perils of the tiny viruses that often attack those whom our responders are called to rescue.
Support them in their courage and dedication that they may continue to save lives, ease pain, and mend the torn fabric of lives and social order. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, amen.
The scriptures are clear. We are responsible for the poor among us. Jesus mentions the poor and the needy more than almost any other group. The Bible reveals to us a God who does not look down on the poor, but values the personhood of each individual, whether they be rich or poor. Today we journey to Circle in Renville, where we have some incredible workers who show us the heart and compassion of Christ. We thank God for their work. We thank God that they can be our hands and our feet, caring for the poor in our midst. Let us pray. God of compassion, whose Son became poor for our sake, help us to see the face of Christ in those who are poor, and in serving them, help us to know that we are serving you. Give us generous hearts so that those living in poverty may have adequate food, clothing, and shelter, especially in this time of pandemic when so many are living with less. By your Spirit, move us to affirm the dignity of all people and to work for just laws that protect the most vulnerable in society through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. Our tapestry of praise and thanksgiving takes us to the food shelves which serve our area. Neighbors United, serving the Yellow Medicine County and the Renville County Food Shelf. The demand for food and help this year has been unprecedented, with so many out of work or those who have had their job hours cut back. Our volunteers have been so faithful to reach out lovingly to the patrons seeking their help and the gifts of so many that have made their gifts possible. Today we give thanks to God for God's abundance of provision and for the privilege that we have of being God's hands reaching out to the needy. Let us pray. O Lord, we pray that you may give us this day our daily bread. We pray not only for us, but for all who are food insecure, for those who do not know where the next meal or rent check will come from. We also pray for the homeless. Grant protection from disease to those unable to practice the protocols of distancing in their places of shelter. Be with our volunteers who tirelessly and selflessly give of themselves, of the loaves and the fishes, when there are so few to give, always trusting in you to multiply their scarce resources. We pray that you may bless and provide abundantly for the needs of the Neighbors United Food Shelf in Granite Falls and for the Renville County Food Shelf in Olivia. Let all know the abundance of your grace and your provision through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Perhaps the greatest hope that we have during these days rests in the labors of the pharmaceutical community, because they are the ones who are developing vaccines and medical treatments that are safe and effective at a speed that has never been seen before. While the numbers of patients that are being admitted to hospitals is still increasing, there are promising treatments that have been developed, and there are many others on the horizon that will reduce the risk of death. Today, we thank God for the scientists who are working at warp speed to aid the ill. Let us pray.
We have hope, O Lord. We thank you for those who have been working tirelessly through the year to bring us vaccines that will give protection from the coronavirus, medicines that offer hopes of healing and cure, garments that shield us from danger, and medical equipment that gives breath when we are too weak, even for a whisper. Bless all those who work in the healing arts with wisdom and knowledge, and by their gifts bring a hasty end to the threats of disease. Through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Every day we receive reports of how many people have contracted the COVID virus, how many people have died, and of those people, how many of them were residents of nursing homes or long-term care facilities. Can you imagine the fear associated with either being a resident or a staff member and knowing that COVID has entered the place where you call home, or your place of gainful employment? Yet day after day, the staff workers here will don their personal protective equipment, praying that just for one more day, they will be spared the disease. This year, we pay tribute to all the heroes who work and live in these facilities. Let us pray. At these days of thanksgiving, O God, we thank you for all who find themselves at home in a care center where their most intimate needs may be provided for, and for all who are tasked with their care. As these centers often find themselves struggling to keep their residents safe from the deadly coronavirus, protect the most vulnerable among us especially those who are in isolation. Grant wisdom and patience and clarity to the healthcare workers, especially as their work caring for others puts themselves at great risk. Guide us as we consider how best to prepare and respond in our families, in our congregations and workplaces and communities. Give us courage to face these days not with fear, but with compassion and concern, with acts of service, knowing that you abide with us always, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. I'm standing here in front of the Renville County Government Office Building. It is here that we have the home of the Renville County Health Department. The workers here, every day, they will laboriously look at the statistics for COVID and put them all together to see how they can create a situation where we are all safer as people. It is a thankless job. They get a lot of complaints because they will be the ones who will recommend whether we open or close, whether we cut back, or whether we can move ahead. Today, I give thanks for these people who are tasked with my safety and with the safety of all of us. Let us pray.
Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, bless the public servants in the government of Redwood, Renville, and Yellow Medicine counties, especially here at the Department of Health. Grant that they may do their work in a spirit of wisdom, charity, and justice. Help them use their authority to serve faithfully and to promote our common life, even when their choices and recommendations fall on critical ears. Through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
Our gratitude prayer drive takes us now to the Olivia Hospital and Clinic. Being that I have four of the women in my family as healthcare workers, I am aware of the challenges that face them every day when they go to work. And when they come home, they wonder, can I hug my children? Is it safe for me to eat at the dinner table with my family? I want to thank God today for all of our healthcare workers, wherever they may be. God has given them courage in order to do their task. And for them, we pray today.
Merciful God, your healing power is everywhere about us. Strengthen those who work among the sick, doctors, nurses, environmental workers, lab and x-ray workers, pharmacists, and office staff. Give them courage and confidence in all they do. In these days when they battle COVID-19, encourage them when their efforts seem futile or when death prevails. Increase their trust in your power, even to overcome death and pain and crying. May they be thankful for every sign of health you give and humble before the mystery of your healing grace. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Keep us all in grace,
Now may the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord's face shine on you and be gracious to you. May the Lord look upon you with favor and grant you peace. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.